Oh, hey. You're here to learn how to scream, aren't you?
This stuff is the magic behind the screaming. I love you. Well, I've got news for you. I'm gonna teach you. No, yeah, I will teach you. Or I'll try to, at least. Okay, first off, in order to scream, anybody can scream. Rule number one is, sell your soul to Satan. Because metal is obviously devil music. No, I'm kidding. But, screaming, it uses the same technique as singing. You have to use your diaphragm. It's right around this region. You gotta push the air out with it. And, gosh, you can't be afraid to get loud whenever you scream. One of the first steps to screaming that I learned, and this helped me out a lot, if you imagine your parents telling you to take out the trash, and like, I don't want to, it's that sound, push harder, see the correlation? But that's false chord style. When it comes to vocal fry, fry screams, power fries, vocal fry, whatever you want to call it, I look at all that as the same thing. It's a completely different technique. Yeah, you use the distortion, but your vocal cords are in a completely different position than the false chords. First off, let's clear something up. Vocal fry, power fries, fry screams, they are not whisper screams. Whisper screams are whisper screams, and they're not even screams. They're just using the back of your tongue. Ah! Sounds like a dying cat. Please don't do that. Hold on, let me fix something. Okay. But I usually fry scream in my videos, like the Devil Wears Prada video. I'll show you a clip right now. And I'll show you a clip of my false chord screams right now. Right now, you can tell the difference between the two. The one in the Devil Wears Prada vocal cover, you can hear my voice a lot more than the other cover. That's the main difference between fry screams and false chord screams. Fry screams use a lot of voice, and it makes them sound a lot more unique, and I look at that as a really good thing. For false chord screams, yeah, they can be a lot more powerful in some aspects, like the lows. The lows will sound a lot more powerful on false chords, but the highs on fry screams can project a lot more than what the highs on false chords could. Also, fry screams on your throat are a lot better than what false chord screams are. They won't tear your throat up as much if you do it correctly, and it makes transition into singing a lot more easier. Anyways, let me get into the technicality of of screaming, of fry screams. Fry screams, I'll show you what it sounds like without the distortion. It's like a falsetto, only you have to project it out loud, like this.
I won't let this ruin me! My indecision in all the black posters. From face to all my age.
Whereas false chord screams, you don't do that at the break of your voice. You do that in your normal voice or make it sound nasally. Like, I'm trying to think. Yeah. I mean, it sounds really stupid without the distortion, but here's what it sounds like with the distortion.
An
The hardest part of screaming is adding the distortion, adding the right amount of distortion, and making it sound good. You chances are you'll get the screaming technique down maybe within a month or two, or 2 months, but it probably will not start sounding good for about 6 months, or that's how it went for me. That's because I did it incorrectly at first, and I lost my voice for a few days. If it hurts, then you're doing it incorrectly. I mean, that's obvious. But if it doesn't hurt, keep going at it. Make sure you smoke a lot of cigarettes and drink a lot of alcohol. And yeah, that will do really good stuff for your throat. Sarcasm. But the distortion part, I mean, just think of that whole... Push hard. Hold your hand on your stomach and breathe. You breathe in with your stomach, not your lungs. Your chest, put one hand on your chest and one hand on your stomach. And if you breathe in, your hand on your stomach should be going out, not the hand on your chest. See, I just breathed my chest. And here's my stomach now. You can see the difference. That'll build up the strength in your lungs. And that'll make screaming a lot more easier. And plus, it won't force the air through your throat, and it will hurt a lot less at first. But I mean, if you want to drink water or tea to make your throat feel better, feel free to. But I mean, I don't do that stuff. I never did that stuff. I just kept pushing and pushing myself, which I really shouldn't have. I'm sure my screams would sound a lot better if I didn't push myself as hard, but just practicing an hour a day will always help you out. I used to practice about an hour a day. I would, the summer I was going into 10th grade, to get my screams to sound like Mike Hiranica's from The Devil Wears Prada, I just screamed the With Roots Above CD one time through each day, every day. And you just add voice into your fry scream. It's really simple. It is. People overcomplicate screaming, just like I overcomplicated singing, and I still kind of do. But, I mean, if you all have any more questions, just shoot me a message or leave it in the comments below, and I'll touch up on it in another video. But my parents are home right now, and I can't really scream. But, here in a couple days, if this doesn't clear things up, I'll make another video trying to clear things up with me screaming in it, so I can show you all a lot more of this technical stuff that you all might ask about. Yeah, I love you all. Hopefully you all learned something. If you all didn't, then I suck. I'm sorry. I love you all. Peace.